Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to second lecture of chapter 4, solidification and crystalline imperfections in solids. As we explained last time, two parts to the chapter. One is about solidification and the other is about imperfections or defects at the crystal. Let us see what we will be doing today. As usual, we will initially review what we covered in lecture 1 of chapter 4 last time, and today we will continue with crystalline imperfections or defects. Line defects, which have dislocations, edge, screw and mix type. Planar defects, which include grain boundaries, twin boundaries and some other defects, and volume defects. After that, we start another major topic of the chapter, experimental techniques, including microstructure. So here we will cover optical microscopy to look at the grain boundaries, which means we'll discuss grain size number and average grain diameter. Then higher level microscopes, scanning electron microscope and transmission electron microscope. As always, we don't know how much of this we will actually be able to cover, but this is our ambitious target for today. Let us see what we covered last time. We talked of metallic solid solutions, alloys, what is an alloy, what is a solid solution, substitutional solid solution, solubility, electronegativity, the Hume-Rothery rule, more about solvent atom solute, an example on substitutional solid, a bigger example on substitutional solid solution and how to find the percent solubility and so on. Continuing with the example, then interstitial solid solution, talking of voids or interstices and distortion in the lattice and so on. A schematic diagram to explain interstitial solid. An example about calculating the radius in interstitial solid solution. Details of the example. Further details of the example in terms of geometry. Then crystalline imperfections or defects. A brief coverage of it. So all the categories, point defects, line defects, planar defects, volume defects and so on. Then we started with point defects. The main one is vacancy, where energy and plastic deformation are important. And we are explaining what is a vacancy. And then we left you at point defects further, right? So that is where we were last time. And we discussed in that interstitial C also. Point defects in ionic crystals a little more. Cation, anion dye vacancy, Schottky imperfection, Frenkel imperfection. Geometrical details of Schottky and Frenkel imperfections. Right? This much we covered in detail. And here we left you. Line defects. Right? So we just opened this slide for you. But we took leave, and so this was where we ended. So let us start today's lecture and cover from where we left last time. We left you at line defects, right? We had finished the four types of point defects. So now we go to line defects. The most famous type of line defect is called dislocation. It is called dislocation. And there may be different types of dislocations we will see. When we were talking about chapter 6 mechanical properties, if you remember, I don't know, it's a long time ago, but if you remember, we told you that some of the problems in mechanical properties are there because of the movement of dislocations. When materials are deformed, dislocations move, dislocations stop at grain boundaries, then another dislocation comes that also stops at grain boundary, there is a dislocation pileup and so on, right? So those we told you that at that point, just try to understand that dislocations are some types of defects at the crystal level, and now we are talking of dislocation, right? So first of all, dislocations are formed during solidification. The metal is completely molten and you are solidifying it.
So some dislocations can form them, or some permanent plastic deformation is happening, just like we told you now that there is some material in a solid state metal and we are trying to pressurize it, force it into a different shape. So in this plastic deformation, some dislocations can be there. Vacancies, right? Vacancies are there. And if many vacancies join together, condensate, then they can make a line defect, right? Each vacancy is a point defect. If many vacancies join together to make a line defect, then there is a dislocation. And there is an atomic mismatch in solid solutions. We told you, right, Hume-Rothery rules that the solid solution, the two different atoms should be at least 15% different in diameter, this, that. So if there is some mismatch. So there are four reasons why dislocations are formed: during solidification, during plastic deformation, because of vacancy condensation, or because of some type of mismatch. Now, because of any reasons, if dislocation forms, there are three types of dislocations: edge dislocation, screw dislocation, and mixed dislocation. So we will do them one by one. And we initially talk of edge dislocation. Edge dislocation. We'll show you in a diagram just now. It is an extra half plane of atoms. Extra half plane of atoms. And its symbol is like this or like this. This is a T or this is an inverted T, right? So if it is this inverted T, it means a positive edge dislocation. If it is a normal T as a symbol, it means a negative edge dislocation. And each edge dislocation is created because there is an extra half plane of atoms inside the materials. And if we want to find the size of the dislocation, we will see on the next page, there is something called a Burger's vector. This is not the burger you eat. Burger is the name of scientists also. For example, Christian Burger was a scientist. So the scientist who studied these dislocations, he defined a vector. So it is named after him, Burger's vector, B, right? This vector is perpendicular to the edge dislocation line. And if we know the size of the Burger's vector, then we know the size of the dislocation, right? So let us see now. Let us see. So you see, let us see on the left hand side. We are showing you planes after planes after planes, right? There is one plane of atom, below it, there is another, below it, there is another, below it, there is another. So we are looking from the top. We are looking from the top. And there are lots and lots of planes, one below the other, right? First plane, below another plane, and this is how they look. This is how you see each of the line is one planar line. So all these atoms are on one plane, then the next plane, and so on. So atoms are like this. Now, because of extra chemical energy, because of extra kinetic energy, some extra atoms are here now, suppose, right? This is also a whole plane of atoms, not only on the top face, bottom face, below it, it also goes all the way down. But this extra plane of atoms is there. Now, it is not here, you see? So here they are normal. But here some extra plane, so it is pushing out, you see? This is pushing it out. So here they are on this location, but here they are pushed out a little, here they are pushed out a little, here they are pushed out maximum. So all of these atoms are affected, they are distorted, because some extra half plane of atoms has been pushed inside. Far away from this, this is the normal situation. So this is the normal A, right? The normal A size and so on. But close to this, so this is, you see, this is this inverted T. Inverted T means that the extra plane of atoms is above here. If this T was normal T, then the extra plane of atoms would be here. So this is the symbol that above it, there is extra plane of atoms. And because of that, there is an edge dislocation. There is a dislocation which is on a line, which is on a line. On each plane, there is a line. And this line is a line of distortion. If you see here now, we are showing you a 3D figure in terms of squares and cubes, right? This square is there, this square is there. So you can think that if you see the 3D, the full 3D picture, then there is a cube. So now each square is there and so on. We are showing that the extra dislocation is here. So this is the extra line of atoms. right? So because of this extra line of atoms, this line of atom is pushed outward, that is pushing that line of atoms also. Similarly, this extra line of atoms pushes this line outward, this line outward. This was a straight line initially, a straight line, but this has been pushed out, right? Far away from this, lines are okay. Lines are okay. This line and this line is exactly 90 degrees, right? But here, this is not 90 degrees anymore. So this is a distortion. And anywhere, if you see the size of this, then this is the Burger's vector. And the size of this will tell you how much distortion there is. There is more distortion close to the line, and as you go away, there will be less distortion, right? So we are explaining from this diagram and from this diagram the same phenomenon. This inverted T here or this inverted T here means the same thing, that above this location, there is an extra half plane of atoms. And if you see only on this front plane, not at the back, only on this front plane, then this is a line. Then this is a line. But actually, it is a 3D thing, but we are seeing it only on this front plane, right? So this is known as an edge dislocation. Now, as I told you earlier, we are doing sort of a brief discussion here. This is the first time in your life that you are studying defects or imperfections at the crystal level. So we are not going to become champions. We should have just a little idea. If we take a second course in material science, if you take a third course in material science, if you do a master's or a PhD in material science, then of course we will do much, much more detail of these same things. So this is enough for edge